Where are we going?
To the hospital.
Awesome. You're in a high five, bud. You're in a good mood. Love it.
Jackson has his leg surgery today to help hopefully correct some of the bowing that's pretty severe in his legs. And we chose the surgery that's the least invasive. The surgery involves putting screws and plates into his growth plates to hopefully slow down growth. And his legs will still be bowed. However, over time, as he grows, they will be straightened out. And it's like the least amount of recovery time. It's supposed to be a pretty quick recovery.
All right, say bye-bye.
Bye-bye, and I am my doctor.
That's good.
Jackson is in very good spirits, which is encouraging, going to the hospital.
But he doesn't know what's happening. Yeah. Like, he's not aware that he's about to, like, go into surgery.
We have told him he's having surgery, but he doesn't
know what that means.
He doesn't know what that, like, he does not know what is coming.
Yeah.
We're trying to stay positive for Jackson, so, you know, we don't want to put any scary ideas into his head. Where are we?
In the hospital.
All right, we're gonna go check in.
Bad.
What? Last night we dropped off Lila at my mom's house so we can focus all of our attention on Jackson. Can you give Lila another hug? Right, bye-bye. Well, you didn't have to say that part again. We're not worried about Lila at all. She's gonna have a ton of fun with Mimi and Chris and be in good hands, and it'll take something off our thoughts. We doing good, Mom?
He's doing good.
He is doing good.
Okay, he already got a toy.
Yeah, look
he's
at
got
you.
A special gown. This kid's ready.
It's a lot of sitting around, talking to doctors.
A lot of different nurses.
A lot of different nurses asking the same questions. All right, here we go.
Thumbs up.
All right,
come on.
For me, it's a constant like worry that like, is Jackson all of a sudden gonna like freak out and say, I don't wanna do this? Or like, is he gonna like, something gonna trigger him to like, be like, I'm not okay with this, you know? So it's just that roller coaster of like, uh-oh, what's gonna happen?
Like, I was nervous for when they would like, come and wheel him away. I was ready to be like, keep it together, Tori. Like, don't get upset. Just like, let him go.
Okay, bye-bye. You're not worried at all?
Oh, I'm definitely worried.
Yeah?
Definitely stressed.
I was definitely worried. Like, your kid's unconscious somewhere in the hospital getting his, like, a screw screwed into his bone. Like, I was worried.
Then I got curious about the recovery. Like, oh, I wonder how he's gonna wake up. Is he gonna be in pain? Risks with surgeries and everything, which is always nerve-wracking.
Are you doing good?
I'm ready to see him.
Yeah.
This waiting business.
Same here. All right, Jackson's in surgery. We just got a text that he's almost done. So it sounds like everything went well. We'll meet with the doctor and then...
waiting for the surgeon now.
Yeah, we'll go in and see him.
We were in the cafeteria while he was in surgery for about 2 hours. What I really appreciated about the hospital is they like kept us updated on everything, but it was the longest 2 hours I've ever had in my life. About 5-10 minutes into us being in the recovery room, as you could tell, the anesthesia had like totally worn off and like the numbing, everything was kind of wearing off. And so he then went from being super content to being really uncomfortable to then like crying, being inconsolable, not being able to get his pain under control.
Is that rough?
That was hard to watch.
I think as like his mom, when he gets hurt, I'm the one he comes to. And like me not being able to like calm him down, that was hard. Like it was really hard to like just watch.
What are we doing, Jackson?
Gosh.
You got your pal Bunny there? You just saw a very different Jackson, and it's like, that's a very hurt Jackson emotionally, and he's physically hurt.
We want Jackson to feel better, and we hope he feels comfortable as soon as possible.
Thank you. just to let the dog out.
Okay.
Hang on, bud. Hey, we're home.
You good?
Yep. We'll set you down on the couch.
Are you comfy?
Yeah.
Okay, we'll get you a bigger blanket too, okay?
It's been a long day, and we're happy to be home, happy to be out of the hospital. I think now it's just recovery time and just making sure Jackson has what he needs and comfortable, and we're aware of where he's at. We don't miss his medication schedule and keep him as comfortable as possible, but then also help him, you know, get back to his normal self.
You feeling okay, Jackson?
Yeah.
You were a rock star today.
You really were.
Do you put ranch in there?
No, I didn't put ranch in there. No ranch. Still high as a kite.
Always can eat on the couch.
But special time.
Such a treat.
You're so sticky from all those popsicles. How many did you eat? Maybe a lot more than one. Jackson, I think you ate 3 popsicles.
I think he did too.
Which is probably why you threw up. So we're in this recovery room. She goes, oh, he has to get up and walk. So he jumps up from his bed, literally like, okay, and is like ready to start walking. And then he sits down and just gets really focused, throws up everywhere, like all over the bed, like just red popsicle everywhere. And he just like, he's never thrown up before. That was the first time he'd ever thrown up. So he's literally like, Mom, I'm so sorry. I didn't tell you I was gonna throw up.
Can't take any baths or showers for a week.
Ooh, you're gonna be smelly.
Mom, we have to tomorrow. Jackson, we're gonna get your walker in here. And tomorrow we have to try to take a few steps, okay?
This recovery is all about getting moving. Starting tomorrow, we gotta get him up on his feet. Mm-hmm. You know, the sooner the better. Just making sure he doesn't get too complacent. Get him on his walker.
Yeah.
A few steps at a time. That's the recovery. They said within 2 weeks he should be, you know, back to normal. But that means we gotta start doing all these things to help that happen.
You smell like popsicle.